We're gonna start when they get right there.
Is this on? Good. Here they come. Oh my gosh. Class of 2021, please be seated. Good morning. My name is Rachel Sipp, and to my side is Jimmy Castillo Rodriguez. We will start the ceremony with a land acknowledgement. In the spirit of truth and reconciliation, we acknowledge that we are on the original ancestral homelands of the Confederated Tribes of Grand Ronde, the Odfaladi, the Kalapuya, and the Cowlitz tribes. We pay homage to their enduring presence and resistance on their land where we learn and live. We also honor our African ancestors for their forced and unpaid labor that built much of the Americas. And now, it is our honor to welcome our families, our staff, Superintendent Grotting, Board Chair Becky Timchuk. We are so happy that we can gather together to celebrate this wonderful class of 2021. And please hold your applause until Jimmy speaks.
Buenos dias. Mi nombre es Jimmy Castillo Rodriguez. Y a mi lado, Rachel Sipp, directora de Merlo Station Campus. Nos gustaría comenzar con un reconocimiento de tierras. En el espíritu de la verdad y la reconciliación, reconocemos que estamos en las tierras ancestrales originales de los Odfaladi, las tribus confederadas de las tribus Grand Ron, Kalapuya y Cowlitz. Rendimos homenaje a su presencia duradera y resistencia en su tierra donde aprendemos y vivimos. También honramos a nuestros antepasados africanos por su trabajo forzado y no remunerado que construyó gran parte de las Américas. Es nuestro honor dar la bienvenida a nuestras familias, nuestro personal, Superintendente Grady y miembro de la Junta Directiva Becky Timchuk. Estamos tan felices que podemos juntarnos todos para celebrar la clase maravillosa de 2021. And while I'm still up here, I want to give a big thank you to my counselor Ula, my counselor Jeremy, my family, and all my friends for pushing me through this year and getting me to the end. Thank you.
Thank you, Jimmy. Class of 2021, you have faced a school year like no other. We will remember this class as the one that survived and often thrived during a global pandemic, a time of great political and social unrest, raging Oregon fires, an ice storm that left many without power, all while going to school online with a school structure never previously experienced. Just one of those events would be a lot for a year. That you have arrived here today shows great personal strength and resilience, and I hope that you recognize that in yourself and each other. Graduates, we've learned so much from you. You rose to the challenge of 2021. You supported younger siblings, cousins, nieces, and nephews with their online schoolwork. You made future plans in a variable and uncertain time. You became essential workers in a pandemic. You faced economic, emotional, and health challenges. You are resilient, you are strong, and you have arrived. Let's give them a hand. Today, you will hear from the wisdom and the reflection from your classmates and a song from our staff band, The Square Root. Then you will walk across the stage and receive your diploma. It is my honor to introduce our first student speaker, Alicia Carrasco.
Honored guests, Merlo teachers and staff, and my fellow graduates in the class of 2021. I've never done anything like this before, speaking in front of a large crowd. I have always tried to avoid doing presentations unless it was in front of less than 10 people. I have always been scared to speak in front of large crowds. But then, when I thought of a graduation speech, I started thinking, what if I did and how would it affect me? Honestly, I think facing your fears is important because once you do it, there's no better feeling. And that is going to be my mindset from now on. I have been scared of a lot of things. First days of schools, presentations, talking to certain people, transferring schools, my first job, and letting go of my grandma when she passed. But I got through all of it. I even think all of those things have made me the person I am today. And this is the day I've been looking forward to since I first attended at Merlo. These four crazy years were stressful and hard. When I started my freshman year, graduation was the last thing on my mind. I started at my home high school and I was a complete mess, always skipping classes, never turning anything in, and I never took school seriously. My attendance was so bad that my counselor recommended switching schools. I had long talks with my parents, friends, and teachers about how I could switch it all around. And honestly, I still didn't care. I thought it was all pointless. After lots of contemplation, I decided to give Merlo a try. Merlo switched it all around. I immediately got the attention I needed. I had smaller classes, and I actually started to enjoy school. I made friends on the first day and made amazing connections with my teachers. I wasn't alone though. My older brother also attended the same school and he was the one who showed me around, introduced me to people, and helped me feel comfortable in a new situation. I want to thank him specifically for that because it helped me more than anything. This last year was our most stressful and difficult, especially since we did our senior year during a pandemic. I think that was the hardest part. We were all confused and lost, didn't know how school was going to play out for our senior year. I was scared I wasn't going to be able to graduate. During online classes, I wasn't getting the attention I needed. I needed to talk in person to be able to understand what was going on. I didn't think I'd make it, but then again, here we all are. I couldn't be more thankful to be here about to walk across this stage. I wouldn't be the same person I am right now than who I was 4 years ago. I don't know that girl anymore. She's my past, and my future is coming soon. I would like to thank my parents for giving me everything I've ever wanted and needed, so many things I never deserved. They've supported me through literally everything. They supported me to this point. My three brothers have pushed me to do my best in school and have stuck by me through everything, but most importantly, they brought my beautiful nephews into this world. I want to thank my Aunt Tammy for partly raising me and being one of the strong women I look up to today. Thank you to my sister-in-law, Brittany, for all our late night conversations that go on forever. They help me get through my problems, and I get to just let everything out. Thank you to the rest of my family for supporting me endlessly and giving me unconditional love. And another small but yet super big thank you to my grandma. Even though she's not here physically, I know she's proud and looking down at me smiling. I did this for her and myself. Lastly, my teachers at Merlo are who I have to thank for where I am today. I never thought I would be here right now. I think what helped was that they never stopped letting me know I was capable of doing it and that I was able to accomplish whatever I set my mind to. I love how they're not just our teachers, they're more like our friends. Thank you to the teachers and my peers. If I had to give my younger self some advice, it would be, it's all worth it in the end. There's no better feeling than accomplishing your dream. Stick through it. I'm proud of myself, not because I'm finally done with high school, but also because I am the first in my family to graduate high school, and it feels really good. I'm also proud of every senior graduating today. We did it. I'm excited to see what the future holds for us all. It's all up to us now. Thank you for listening, and congratulations, class of 2021. I'd like to welcome to the stage our second speaker from the class, Eli Portwood.
I'd like to start with a few thank yous. I'd like to thank my teachers for their patience and their dedication to our education. I'd also like to thank this community for welcoming me with open arms. I'd like to thank my friends who stayed by me throughout the year. Lastly, I'd like to thank my mom for believing in me. Each of us as individuals has a goal. Many of us want to be doctors, veterinarians, mechanics, musicians, actors, and many other professions. For all of us, our journey has just begun. One lesson I've learned throughout the years is the road to success is going to be long and hard. Many of us had traveled down different roads, different struggles, different hurdles to jump. But one part is consistent in all of our journeys is that we've all taken our first step in accomplishing our goals. We've all worked hard. We've all graduated. This is the time to reflect on the trail we have just walked down, to see what we have already done and how far we have to go. But this is also the time to celebrate what we have accomplished, to acknowledge that we have just completed 12 years of schooling. 12. So kick it for today, celebrate your achievements, and relax, for tomorrow is a new beginning. I would like to invite the faculty band, Square Root, to the stage for a special performance.
Congratulations, graduates. Good for you. Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question, but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end there's right. I hope you have the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind. Hang it on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos of memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end there's right. I hope you had the time of your life. But in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life.
All right, I would like to invite Kimberly Hernandez Huerta, class of 2021 salutatorian, to the stage, please.
Hello. Hello, everyone. My name is Kimberly. I am the salutatorian of class of 2021. First and foremost, I would like to say congratulations to the class and thank you to family, friends, and teachers for being part of my journey on getting my diploma. I have been here at Merlo since my first day of my freshman year of high school. I remember like it was just yesterday when for the first time I saw a transcript and it said I needed 24 credits. I thought to myself, this is going to take a long time to complete. However, in a blink of an eye, I was in my junior year and ready to take early college classes. When I got accepted to my first college course, it was CG100. I was so happy, and I still have the paper that says congratulations in big letters. Over this last year, we've had more separated classes. Some of you, like me, have been working night shifts, taking courses on lunch breaks, and helping family members, and trying to complete all of our credits. But we made it to this day. Over these 4 years, I met a lot of amazing people, beginning with my freshman avid teacher, Kathy. Thank you, Kathy. Even though I was a handful, you never stopped believing in me and every day motivated me to continue pushing myself. Another amazing person that inspired me was Will. Even though he's not here physically, I know he's here and proud of us. For the people who didn't know Will, he brightened every room he walked into. He was a person who would motivate everyone to getting our diploma. I remember when I would go to school not feeling the best, he would never fail to put a smile on my face. Now I could say, Will, I finally did it. I got my diploma. All of my teachers played a part in me being here today. Thank you. I would like to take a moment to share a message with my parents. Me gustaría agradecerle a mis padres por apoyarme siempre. Gracias por estar ahí cada vez que los necesité. Quería decirles que ese diploma representa todo su esfuerzo y que los quiero mucho. Gracias. Thank you. To the class of 2021, I hope our future plans and goals are reached, and we are all here to celebrate an amazing day because we deserve it. Thank you and congratulations. I would like to invite Community School Class of 2021 Valedictorian Abigail Knighton to the stage.
Hello and welcome, Class of 2021. Not only did you graduate high school, you did it with more obstacles than most. High school is a difficult time to navigate, even without the added stress of a global pandemic and a new way to learn. You've accomplished something huge. Congratulations. To all the staff at Merlo, our family, friends, and other supporters here today, thank you. We could not have made it without your support and guidance. Each of us here today has a story to tell about our lives, what growing up was like, why we came to Merlo, our hopes and dreams for the future, and so much more. My story is messy and complicated, and I hate it. I don't like telling my story at all. I can imagine some of you here today feel the same way. One thing I learned while at Merlo is that it's important to tell your story. Even when you don't like your story, sharing it is how you make authentic connections with the people around you. You can't expect to get to know anyone or have anyone get to know you in a way that matters if you're not willing to tell your story, even the parts that you don't like. One of the biggest parts of my story, and coincidentally, my least favorite part of my story, is the part that I would like to share with you today because it's what taught me the biggest lesson of my life. For as long as I can remember, everything has worried me way more than it should. I get nervous and overwhelmed about the smallest things, and I was never able to understand why that was. I spent all my time overthinking things and planning out how I thought things should go, how they might go, worst case scenarios, and so on. My anxiety runs through almost all my thoughts, and sometimes it feels like my story might even revolve around my anxiety. When it came time for me to go to high school, every aspect of my life was changing around me, and it was making my anxiety worse than it had ever been. My mom moved 800 miles away, I had to start high school in a new city without any of my friends, and I was going from a private school with less than 600 students to a public one with almost 2,000. I was terrified. Nothing was going how I planned it should. I wanted my mom to take me to my first day and my friends to be there with me. That wasn't possible though. I didn't want to have to be around that many people, and I did, 5 days a week. I was so upset that high school wasn't going to be how I planned it would. It really wasn't what I wanted at all. I absolutely hated going to school. My attendance was horrible, and every day I did end up going to school, I wished I hadn't. Even just driving by the school put my stomach in knots. Soon enough, my anxiety got to the point that I started having panic attacks. My panic attacks are a little unusual. I don't hyperventilate or cry or get jumpy, I just faint. I would get so overwhelmed that my body just stops and I pass out. Before they knew why it was happening, I had to do all my schoolwork from home because every time I went to school, I would faint. Now high school really wasn't going how I wanted it to. All of it just made me more anxious. Nothing was going how I planned it would. Nothing was going how I thought it should. Absolutely nothing was going my way, and I felt like all of it was my fault. I had it planned. I knew how things were supposed to happen, so why in the world were they not going that way? As I've gone through high school, moved the 800 miles my mom did to be with her, and found my place in the Merlo community, I've learned so many things about myself and about life. By far the most important thing I learned, though, is that no matter how much I worry, plan, or fixate on how I think something should go, it almost never does. I spent so much of my life upset that things didn't go how I wanted them to, And through the ups and downs of high school, this pandemic, and even just the last month, I think I've come to realize and accept that things will never go how I plan them. But they will still happen, and they can be amazing if I let them. I would like to finish today by saying that even if things didn't go the way you wanted them to throughout high school, you still made it. Even though the pandemic ruined our chance of a normal senior year, even though you probably had a million things to worry about, even though it's been a really difficult road to make it here today, you made it. I keep telling myself that I don't deserve to be standing here today, but I do, and so do you. No matter what happened between kindergarten and today, you still put in the work for over 12 years to be standing here, and I'm so proud of you. I hope you're proud of yourself.
Well, everybody, the moment we've been waiting for is here. Class of 2021, I have a final ask for you. When it comes time, don't rush across this stage. This is your moment. Take as long as you want. Pause. Look out at this community. Find your friends, find your family, find your favorite teachers. And if you don't trust my advice, listen to Ferris Bueller. He said, life moves pretty fast. If you don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it. So take your time, and in the words of our late and great Will Andrews, it's time to get that diploma, y'all. Row one. Row one of class of 2021, please stand.
Abigail Rose Knighton.
Kimberly Hernandez Huerta.
Avery Ryan Abel Crane. Kendale Safeth Barrow. Dakota Boren.
Alicia Rose Carrasco. Jimmy Castillo Rodriguez.
Daisha Chapman.
Karen G. Giselle Del Cid.
Connor Isaiah Doty. Angel Marie Heron. Nolan Scott Harper.
Samantha Hernandez Huerta.
Emily Sarah Knutson. D'Artagnan Lewis.
Erica Vanessa Martinez.
Idris Muhammad.
Yaden Mora. Edwin Antonio Morales Almiraya.
Faisal Muala.
Jesús Salvador Mujica Díaz.
Cameron Nam Kalen.
Ruby Natalie Olmos. Leslie Mirel Pliego Sánchez.
Yeah,
Eli Portwood. Noel Ray Rauscher.
That's so beautiful.
Michelle Reyes.
Joseph Sherbach.
Perla Abigail Silva Sánchez.
Cheyenne Soli.
Adrián Vallejo. Alía Villegas Vargas.
Tanner Neftali Wagner Rivera. Alice Watterson Woods.
About our lives, what growing up was like, why we came to Merlo, our hopes and dreams for the future, and so much more. My story is messy and complicated, and I hate it. I don't like telling my story at all. I can imagine some of you here today feel the same way. One thing I learned while at Merlo is that it's important to tell your story. Even when you don't like your story, sharing it is how you make authentic connections with the people around you. You can't expect to get to know anyone or have anyone get to know you in a way that matters if you're not willing to tell your story, even the parts that you don't like. One of the biggest parts of my story, and coincidentally, my least favorite part of my story, is the part that I would like to share with you today because it's what taught me the biggest lesson of my life. For as long as I can remember, everything has worried me way more than it should. I get nervous and overwhelmed about the smallest things, and I was never able to understand why that was. I spent all my time overthinking things and planning out how I thought things should go, how they might go, worst case scenarios, and so on. My anxiety runs through almost all my thoughts, and sometimes it feels like my story might even revolve around my anxiety. When it came time for me to go to high school, every aspect of my life was changing around me, and it was making my anxiety worse than it had ever been. My mom moved 800 miles away, I had to start high school in a new city without any of my friends, and I was going from a private school with less than 600 students to a public one with almost 2,000. I was terrified. Nothing was going how I planned it should. I wanted my mom to take me to my first day and my friends to be there with me. That wasn't possible though. I didn't want to have to be around that many people, and I did, 5 days a week. I was so upset that high school wasn't going to be how I planned it would. It really wasn't what I wanted at all. I absolutely hated going to school. My attendance was horrible, and every day I did end up going to school, I wished I hadn't. Even just driving by the school put my stomach in knots. Soon enough, my anxiety got to the point that I started having panic attacks. My panic attacks are a little unusual. I don't hyperventilate or cry or get jumpy, I just faint. I would get so overwhelmed that my body just stops and I pass out. Before they knew why it was happening, I had to do all my schoolwork from home because every time I went to school, I would faint. Now high school really wasn't going how I wanted it to. All of it just made me more anxious. Nothing was going how I planned it would. Nothing was going how I thought it should. Absolutely nothing was going my way, and I felt like all of it was my fault. I had it planned. I knew how things were supposed to happen, so why in the world were they not going that way? As I've gone through high school, moved the 800 miles my mom did to be with her, and found my place in the Merlo community, I've learned so many things about myself and about life. By far the most important thing I learned, though, is that no matter how much I worry, plan, or fixate on how I think something should go, it almost never does. I spent so much of my life upset that things didn't go how I wanted them to, And through the ups and downs of high school, this pandemic, and even just the last month, I think I've come to realize and accept that things will never go how I plan them. But they will still happen, and they can be amazing if I let them. I would like to finish today by saying that even if things didn't go the way you wanted them to throughout high school, you still made it. Even though the pandemic ruined our chance of a normal senior year, even though you probably had a million things to worry about, even though it's been a really difficult road to make it here today, you made it. I keep telling myself that I don't deserve to be standing here today, but I do, and so do you. No matter what happened between kindergarten and today, you still put in the work for over 12 years to be standing here, and I'm so proud of you. I hope you're proud of yourself.
Well, everybody, the moment we've been waiting for is here. Class of 2021, I have a final ask for you. When it comes time, don't rush across this stage. This is your moment. Take as long as you want. Pause. Look out at this community. Find your friends, find your family, find your favorite teachers. And if you don't trust my advice, listen to Ferris Bueller. He said, life moves pretty fast. If you don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it. So take your time, and in the words of our late and great Will Andrews, it's time to get that diploma, y'all. Row one. Row one of class of 2021, please stand.
Abigail Rose Knighton.
Kimberly Hernandez Huerta.
Avery Ryan Abel Crane. Kendale Safeth Barrow. Dakota Boren.
Alicia Rose Carrasco. Jimmy Castillo Rodriguez.
Daisha Chapman.
Karen Giselle Del Cid.
Connor Isaiah Doty.
Thank you.
Angel Marie Heron. Nolan Scott Harper.
Samantha Hernandez Huerta.
Emily Sarah Knutson. D'Artagnan Lewis.
Erica Vanessa Martinez.
Idris Muhammad.
Leah Yaden Mora. Edwin Antonio Morales Almiraya.
Faisal Muala.
Jesús Salvador Mujica Díaz.
Cameron Nam Kalen.
Ruby Natalie Olmos. Leslie Mirel Pliego Sánchez.
Yeah,
Eli Portwood. Noel Ray Rauscher.
Michelle Reyes.
Joseph Sherbach.
Perla Abigail Silva Sánchez.
Cheyenne Soli.
Adrián Vallejo. Alía Villegas Vargas.
Tanner Neftali Wagner Rivera. Alice Watterson Woods.
Nayeli Zamudio Avalos.
Staff, please get in position to say goodbye. Class of 2021, please stand. You may now move your tassel from the right to the left. Families, here is your class of 2021. When you hear the music, please exit row by row.